So I think we'll proceed ahead with questions, specific questions. We got 15 minutes and it can be put the both the experts on the dais, please. We'll close out at 1:15. First question could be on the digital twin because that was the sequence of events. So you could take questions one by one on the digital twin.
Hello. Hi, this is Harbinder Chimney here. I wanted to specifically ask in view of, brownfield project implementation, how this tool can be used to pick up as-built, information so that when you're upgrading the plant, it can support in absence of documentation.
Sir, which company?
Worley.
So, great question. And in fact, we are actually working with Worley in UK on a similar project where we are actually using images captured using drones and photogrammetry to process them in our tool. So Bentley has a tool called Context Capture, which allows us to basically cover or takes these images. So the whole process is all about if I have to create a reality model or a brownfield model of this pot, I'll take multiple pictures of this pot around. So I'll have a view from here on the top, few views on the side, and then create a reality model. It's a wire mesh model. And then we use the AI and the ML logics on top of it to say, this is a flower, this is a pot made up of a clay, and then link back to my other systems back. So that's something, a POC, which we have already done with Worley as such, and we can talk more in details about that. But how do I use it back? Now, this reality model which is created, I can bring back into my design tools. So if you're using a PDMS or an open plant, I can bring that models back there and reference them very similar to how I reference another project or a model as such, and continue modeling on that. That's how it's being done across in various projects around it.
Just one small, what is the time frame if you're looking at, say, typically a HNU platform or project, which has, say, around 200 plus equipments, and you are modifying across. So what is the time frame you're looking at building the point model and then getting the data?
So I'll give you an example of a project. I'll not name the company. It's a project in Indonesia, which is using the similar technology which I described back here. They have two units which they started with the project back. The first unit was completed in 3 months. So what they did back was they converted everything into a brownfield 3D model and then linking back information. So typically 3 to 4 months is the timeline around that for per unit for them. And definitely depending on the complexity of the unit, things may change back around that. But that was a typical time period for this Indonesian company who was working on that. Thank you.
Thank you.
My question is addressed to Mr. Amit Shrivastava. I am Dr. D.C. Patra from Bharat Petroleum. I am referring to something relating to digital maturity of an organization and of a country as a whole, if we look at. Reference has been made to McKinsey report, Accenture report, and all these things are very highlighting the fact that something like 13-14% of the potential of digitalization has been kind of achieved, and around 60% of the potential is perhaps fence sitting, and many are to be done. We have been talking of artificial intelligence and machine learning and similar tools of digitalization for not less than last 10 years or so. And if there is a lot of apprehension in the CEO's mind not to do a fast adaptation, though we understand that there is a value, what are those apprehensions primarily and how those apprehensions can be addressed? Thank you.
Great question, sir, because that's the ROI is the key aspect when anybody talks about digitalization. How do I get ROI of what I'm doing today around it? So there are multiple approaches. Like Bentley works with McKinsey very closely. Bentley and McKinsey has actually created what we call it a maturity model. So what we do is we basically work with organizations where we look at where they are, what's their vision in terms of where they want to go in next 5 to 10 years, and then create basically a plan in terms of various phased approach or waves approach, that what do we do in phase one, how do we get an ROI on the phase one. So it's not a big bag approach which we look at. We look at small pieces where we can start getting ROIs on that. It's a very similar concept where it's not just India. Shell talks about it. Shell has their digital transformation initiative is divided into five phases. And they're talking about phase one and phase two to be completed in 2020 and 2021. And it's all about how do I integrate, as Sir said, IT and OT to begin with. Because today, that's the ROI which they can get right away. So they're talking about how do I bring engineering information, how do I get work order management systems, how do I get my sensor IoT data back together to help my operators make decisions around it. So there's various ROI work which they have been working on. Bentley has actually, if you go to Bentley's website, we have published a maturity model. So where we basically invite you to basically answer a few questions. It tells you where you are in the as an organization today in your asset maturity and how can you move towards the next level. So it gives you a very initial framework for that, but we'll be happy to work with you on closing in terms of how do we move forward on that. I would like to close at that point.
I'd like to add on this. When we talk about digital, I think there's a lot of misconceptions about the costs involved, the time involved, and the fact of success. Now, success in a new field where you enter, let us say you are trying to use machine learning for doing trying to estimate some product properties, etc. These are going to be a learning phase if you're using drones, because when we use the drones the first time, we lost the drone for 10 minutes. And there was tension because there was a fear that the police will catch us. The limited point I want to make for any top management is when they are looking at making digitalization in their DNA, they need to look at a 3 to 4 to 5 year horizon. And number one, eat what you want to eat. For example, in supply chain, there's money on the table. If you can do an excellent end-to-end integration using artificial intelligence of predicting demand in the marketplace better than you can predict today and build that data upward to squeeze the asset and go back to the crude, there are already segregated packages available. What is broad digitalization is availability of new technologies and the ability of experimentation and doing it better. So any top management needs to look at not a 1 year horizon, not a 2 year horizon. It is building a digitalizing culture which would take 3 to 4 years. And the class A items would be two. Maintenance and reliability will bring money on the table fast. Number two is anything in supply chain which will make seamless from the customer to the crude. Anything other than that, like health, safety, security, and environment, the management will also have to be taught. Chief operating officers will have to attend a 5-day course on machine learning to know the potential. Otherwise, today what is happening, it's become jargonistic, and the top management is not aware of the potential without loss of jobs. There is potential without loss of jobs as well. Please understand the top context. We will talk during the tea break or something more. But clearly, if you are not entering right now, you would land up at a time where you will get into a situation you will not be able to change with the changing times. Because demands are going to change, everything is going to change. So your response has to be in the minute or the hour. You cannot respond after a month.
We'll discuss during tea break because your question philosophical, it requires something more. Anything on hygiene or any other questions? We've still got about 7-8 minutes. Squeeze it.
No, I understand on the ROI, and you have spoken about 3 to 4 years, 5 years. But let's take a typical example of, say, only one plant or a management of change which is happening in a plant. Correct. Say a cracker or a FCC unit.
Right.
So what is the ROI for that? If you have already done in some environment in the world.
I can tell you what was done. I can tell you in a shutdown of a unit, which is typically 30 days, we did intense job with a startup, did huge amount of use of all kinds of cameras and other things. Finally, CV saved one day. Now, one day on a 30 days may not look too good because all the drawings are available in the site. There was analytics done about the people coming in and out the plant. There was analytics done with the drone on safety incidents. And we could say one day, which is 3 crores, which is not too much, but the potential of the technology was known. Next time we do a shutdown, we'll build on this. The limited point I'm saying, there's money on the table, and clearly it was visible after intense efforts with startups. Point I'm trying to make is, the first time the startup will come, he's also learning. So you cannot expect a standard equation or a formula ready-made. There's a joint learning and it will build up with time. We'll have to be a little patient on the bottom line.